Who knows what evil lives in the heart of games? The Shadows knows.
Hi, I'm The Shadows knows, and I'm back with another pickup video. My mate Tomaniac and I have been to the Retro Dungeon in Belgium today, and we did quite some pickups there. I'll start with the oldest, with the game for the oldest console, Street Racer for the Atari 2600. Have never played this, never heard of this before, except for that Tomaniac likes this very much, and we yes. will try it out later. And yeah, you got some Atari games as well.
Yes, long time no see. Hi mates. Yeah, nothing happens on my channel at the moment, on my English channel, but on my German, the show still goes on. But now I'm here with The Shadows Knows, and yeah, we found some nice games, and I've got a present from him, and believe it or not, I've something about 100 Atari cartridges, but this one still was missing. It's Combat for the Atari. We played it yesterday in two-player, and we had real lots of fun. And another...
Yeah, we recorded a video of it, but it's in German, so you have to watch it on Tomaniac's channel in German.
Yes, I can't promise when it's ready. I try to keep to do it this week, and perhaps it comes out on Saturday, but I can't promise. And then I found Pro Wrestling for the Atari 2600, and I never played this, so we will test this later just for fun. And this is my what I got for the Atari 2600.
Okay, next, second oldest console is the Philips Video Pack. I got the number 57 Blobbers, and I did not pay what is written on the label. Never heard of this before. I don't think I will enjoy this very much, but I'm going for a complete collection for the Philips console, so
cool.
I picked that up. Then I got, which number is this? This is number 19. Oh shit. It's called Catch the Ball. No clue what this is either, but I didn't have it. And then I got number 30, Battlefield. I think I did not have this. I don't have... the Philips games in my catalog, but it was reasonably cheap, so if I already have it, it's not too much waste of money.
This is how the Battlefield series started.
Then I've got number 21, Secret of the Pharaohs.
Uh-huh.
Again, never heard of this, and I'm pretty sure that I did not have this.
Absolutely no clue with these games.
So, yeah, this is the first time for over a year that I could pick up some games for the Philips console. Because I really have a lot of them already, so it's getting really hard to find some for a cheap price that I can still pick up. Yeah, and you don't have anything that old, right?
No. The oldest I have is my Atari 2600.
So let's continue with the Master System games that I picked up. I have Sega Ghostbusters.
Mm-hmm.
In box, without the manual, but at least in box. Then I've got Great Volleyball. Yeah, this was a cheap one. Then I've got Spider-Man.
Mm-hmm.
It looks nice on the
yeah.
back. It looks nice. I'm not sure... You can see some screenshots. I'm not sure if this is a good game, but it was reasonably priced, and I never paid what's written on the label.
I thought about getting this myself, but then no.
Yeah, and finally I got my favorite shoot 'em up for the Master System.
Really cool.
R-Type. And again, I did not pay what is on the non-existent label, or it's on the back side, so you could not see it. And I've got quite a few more Master System games, but I think you show the boxed one first, so we finish
so,
the
yeah,
boxed one.
So yes, then we have finished the boxed ones. It was a very long day. and I had to keep concentrated myself when driving. As you know, I'm from Switzerland, and I came here on Friday night, and there I drove something about 700 kilometers, and then today one way was something about 50 to 80 one way, and then back, and then the day on the retro fair. It's very stressing, and now we are rather tired.
Very tired, yeah, indeed.
But I got a choplifter for the master system, didn't fiddle this out here, and we still have the prices on that. Doesn't matter, I think. So there we have Joblifter, and it's a cool game. I like it all over the systems. I played it on the C64 and on the Atari and so on. And
I have to get some more flashcards, so I can. I think I'm missing the Big 20 version that I can't play right now. I have planned a comparison video of this. I already have this cartridge, but I'm still missing a way to play the VIC 20 version. And probably, I don't know if it was released on the NES, but I maybe cannot play it on the NES either.
Not sure. Perhaps. Yeah.
Not sure.
This is an insider. But, perhaps we explain later. Not sure. It's good. It's great. So we don't have this not sure tattoo.
Yeah.
But we have this. Yeah. Surely we were there. I've got a game version I never heard of before, but it looks really interesting. It's Super Space Invaders for the Master System, and the cover already looks good. And it seems to be possible to play it simultaneously in two player. So it seems to have two spaceships down there.
Oh, that would be cool.
It could be really interesting. I'll show you some screenshots. I hope you can see them. And this looks really interesting. And I really look forward to play this. Then we have a real classic here, Gauntlet 1. It's complete with manual. And I searched for this for longer times. And now I got it. And another one I paid a really good price for. So what we can say, all in all, we really paid good prices. It was...
Yeah, it was a very, very reasonably priced retro fair.
Absolutely.
So well worth going there. And the people also were very, very nice.
Yes.
Again, so I can really recommend Belgium for going to a retro fair.
Mm-hmm. You have to drive far, but it's in the end you get rewarded. It was very, very good. The next I finally found in a reasonable price was Wonder Boy 3 The Dragon's Trap. And there you can see 20. Most of the time they wanted 30 for this, and I've bundled this with another game I can show you here. It's My Hero. There it says 10, and I paid 25 for both of them, and the cover looks really nice. It's nearly new, and it comes with everything, with the manual and the cartridge. And this is something like a side-scrolling beat-em-up, and it looks very nice. I hope you can see here these screenshots. Yeah, next is a hidden gem. I saw this one, I guess it was from Metal Jesus or something there, and it's Cloud Master. It's without manual, but who cares. This is also a side-scrolling shoot-em-up game. And this looks really nice as far as I've seen on YouTube. I never played this myself before, but they say it's really good and a hidden gem. Not all of you may know this. Okay, these are my boxed Master System games.
So I'll continue with the loose cartridge. Yeah, let's have a quick one, because we have quite a lot and they were very, very cheap.
Yeah.
I have Epic Adventure. I've got Cloudmaster. That was one that I picked up
After I showed you.
And you know what I've paid for them, so...
Yeah, okay.
Disney's Aladdin.
Great game on the Master System.
G-Lock.
Don't know what that might be.
Great Basketball.
I think I have this already.
Shadow Dancer. Isn't that a Ninja Gaiden, something like that?
Yeah, you are a ninja and you have a dog as a companion.
Okay.
And this supports you in fighting. Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Then I have Great Golf. I have Mercs.
Mercs?
Sonic 2. Cool. Didn't have that so far.
Yeah, this is strange. I also don't have it.
I have Moonwalker. Mm. Yeah, I discovered the boxes before him, so I got all the good ones.
You will see some of them also in my stack.
Yeah, I've got Dragon Crystal.
Sounds interesting.
Also got Running Battle. Uh-huh. I've never heard of it.
No.
Also got RC Grand Prix.
This sounds interesting.
Back to the Future 2.
Back to Boobs.
And last but not least, Operation Wolf. And I'm not quite sure if I don't have this already.
It might be that you have to use the phaser there.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure. Yeah, okay, so, yeah.
We got all of those loose Sega cartridges from the Retro Games Corner, and I also put a link in the description. Really nice guy.
Yeah.
Really, really nice guy. And he may also make me a good price on R-Type, because I promised him to show the business card, and I also show the back of the business card on my video. Yeah, all the sellers were really nice on that retro burst. So yeah, that's always a nice thing in Belgium, and also in the Netherlands, and also in Germany. Usually on the retro version, all the sellers are very nice. All the other people that are there are very nice. So it's really worth going there. The stuff is usually much cheaper than on eBay, and you can have a look at it. You can put it in your hand, can see if it's in a condition that you like, and it's not a photoshopped photo on eBay that was taken from a completely different copy of the game. So yeah, I really highly recommend going to those retro börsen instead of buying this stuff on eBay.
Yes, what I can add is most of the games I have, something about 99%, I've bought on retro fairs and nowhere else. I really can recommend going there. So some of the games has shown I also have, but I start with Asterix, also a nice platformer. Then Castle of Illusion. You can't go wrong with Disney games on the Master System and also on the Mega Drive. Castle of Illusion for the Mega Drive also is a really nice game.
Yeah, I did a comparison video, but I actually did not like this game too much.
Then I have Kung Fu Kid. Then Action Fighter. Don't know. I hope that I don't need a phaser because it doesn't work on my
I think I did a LCD. Video about this. I have this, so I don't think you need the phaser for this.
Aztec Adventure. Yes. Then, I don't know what this is. Champions of Europe. Is this a racing game or is this a soccer game?
I think it's a soccer game.
Champions of Europe. As I didn't have this in my collection list, I just bought it because the offer was too good to not to say yes.
Yeah, it was ridiculously cheap, to be honest. So I went, he had two boxes full with those loose cartridges, and most of them were packed in this plastic foil, and I picked up all games that I didn't already have on my list. I usually go for box games on the Master System, but for this price I can always get them, and if I get a boxed copy I can still sell them, or if the cartridge
so is auto upgrade
very very good, so it would have been a sin not to pick them up.
Yeah, definitely. Super Monaco GP, the next one. Then I have Summer Games. I really like this sports series, Summer Games. Don't know if it's the same.
I think it's Epic's one.
The one on the C64, for example. So, looking forward to test this. And at last, Moonwalker. I also have this one picked up. So, these are my Master System games.
Yeah, you have to do the Mega Drive one because
yes, I have a Mega Drive.
The only other games that I have are Xbox games. And
I have some hardware for the Master System. This one was missing. I'm playing the Master System games on my Mega Drive with the converter, and I still needed a functioning Master System control pad. The one I have doesn't go left, and this one, yeah, it looks nearly new, and the price 15 euro is totally okay.
Yeah, they are the Master System controllers are much more rare than
yes.
The Mega Drive controllers. The Mega Drive controllers you see everywhere for a buck or two, and if they are in really good condition for $5, or if they are like new for $10. But this was the first time I've seen a Master System controller
and
without a Master System.
Yes,
and we also have seen a second one there. So it was really the first time I've seen one without the actual system.
Normally they only sell this bundled with the console. And this time was the first time that they sold it alone without the console. So yes, I have one Mega Drive game, and as I'm an absolute pinball fan, I collect pinball games of all kinds all over all my systems. I got Psycho Pinball for the Mega Drive, and it says that it has four tables and a dot matrix realistic panel games you can play in the dot matrix and so on. It reminds me a little bit of the Pinball Fantasies and so series, because it's a top-down table view. And what I really like here is the cartridge itself. The Codemasters cartridges are rather special. We have the manual here, and then they have this special shape. And this one especially looks brand new. Also the contacts and such look really good, and I'm really happy that I got another pinball game, and then looking that good, this good condition. Yeah, so now I'm ready with Sega, I guess. Yes.
Yeah, so we finished with Sega, so I'll show you my first hardware pickup. I've got another cartridge. I've got this 200-in-1 multi-card. It's a Famicom cartridge with an adapter. I really don't care about this. I only wanted this, that here, because I got myself a Famicom.
A really big adapter.
So,
cool.
The condition is not perfect. Let's put that clear. It's a little bit dusty, but
it's AV modded.
It's AV modded already.
Great.
So I can use it on a regular TV. The power supply has this American plug, and it's broken. I will not put this into the plug. I will get my own one. But now I have an original Famicom. The controllers feel still okay. And I'm really looking forward to use the microphone in some weird Japanese games.
Oh yes.
So I'm really happy to get this. It was ridiculously cheap again.
It seems there's still the protection sticker on it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. I don't know if you can see
it. So you can peel it off someday.
The protective film over the Famicom logo is still there. So yeah, that was a real great find. And I'm really happy that I bought this 5 minutes after we arrived there. And I guess if I had waited 5 more minutes, it would have been gone.
Definitely.
Especially for that price. So
really cool.
Yeah, you pay more than twice for this without an AV mod in about the same condition. Yeah, that was my first piece of hardware that I picked up. So I think that's the newest console. The Xbox is the newest one. So I think you have to continue.
Yes, okay, so we continue with some Game Boy Advanced games, and 2, 3, 4, 5 this also was a bundle. It was, what did it say, 10 euro, 5 games, something like that, and there's one that's worth them all. But I start with it says Samurai Jack.
Which one is the fake one?
It looks a bit cartoony. When I put it into the Game Boy Advance to test it out, and it looked a bit cartoony, but a nice beat 'em up, side scrolling beat 'em up. One of them is a fake cartridge I've saw just a few minutes ago. So, another pinball game, Pinball Tycoon. Then, the fake one, isn't it? This one seems to be a platformer. Tang Tang, never heard of this. But I had to collect 5 to get the bonus, to get the discount. And then I have a fake cartridge. It says Game Cassette, made in China. And the game is Mazes of Fate, but it's an RPG and it's English, perhaps, I don't know if it's a fan translation or something. So here you can see that this is a fake cartridge, but I don't care if it runs well, so it doesn't matter. But the real burner is Iridion 3D. It has pre-rendered 3D objects. You fly through a tunnel. It's a space shoot 'em up, and it's simply awesome. It has great rendered graphics. It runs absolutely fluently, and it has a real good, great sound. Normally, you don't find this under 10 to 15 euro or more. And so with this bundle, it was 2 euro, so this is really, really awesome. That was really
catch. Use some alcohol to clean it to make it work.
At first it didn't run, but after cleaning it runs like a charm. So this, and then I got some Game Boy Color games. They are a bit simplistic, but who cares? They were cheap. The first is Pocket Racing. And the first impression I got from this is quite good, rather colorful, Game Boy Color, but also it's a nice racer. Then we have, I don't know what it is, but I will do a video and bring this out Halloween, because it's Halloween Racer. I don't have a clue, but perhaps for Halloween. And then M&M's. So the time has come. I had to put on my reading glasses. So, M&M Minis Madness, and perhaps you know M&M's these chocolate drops.
And the fun thing is,
it seems to be
if you turn it around, you have W&W racer. So
okay. So Madness, yeah. Okay, so these are my... I have a last Game Boy Advance game. I nearly have forgot. So, the best combination one can find if you love Pac-Man and pinball games, you can buy Pac-Man Pinball Advance. I never heard of this one, and I didn't pay this 20. He gave me a discount also. Here are some screenshots. I hope you can see them somehow, and this table looks really good, and it's still completely sealed, so I don't know Will I open this sometime? I guess, because when I buy games, I buy them because I like to play them. And as I didn't find the loose cartridge, I had to buy this complete. And yeah, the seller says you can keep the cartridge and throw away the carton. I won't do this.
And the Xbox is still newer than the PS2, so.
Yeah, and also newer than the GameCube. Yeah, I think. So, with his loot box, he got this bag, and as we opened it, we found a game in there. They forgot this. It's nice to carry GameCube games, and there was one game still left in there, and it's in a real great shape. It doesn't have any scratches. It looks brand new. So they put it in there and forgot it. It's a Star Wars Rogue Leader, Rogue Squadron for the GameCube. And as I have a GameCube, so he gave it to me as a present. No manual and such, but hey, it's for free, so I don't ask.
It's quite a good price, I guess.
Definitely. And the last one, then I'm through with all my... The last one, yeah. I have. Normally I didn't want to collect any more PlayStation 2 games because I have more than 100 and there are simply something about 60 or more I didn't have done, or I haven't done a video about, and I really have to start doing videos because I don't have enough storeroom anymore to collect any more PS2 games. But more by accident, I saw this one and I couldn't resist. I had to get it, and it's R-Type Final, and this is simply awesome, and so I couldn't resist. I had to take this. Yeah. Modify and choose from over 100 chips. Select from 160 weapons and power-ups. So this is stuff for ages to play with. And I really like these arcadic games when you play some minutes and then the next one and so. And as I really love R-Type and this series, I had to get this one. So these are all the games I've picked up so far, and now it's your turn.
Yeah, again. I will finish this now. So I got a couple of Xbox games. First of all, Serious Sam.
I have this on the PC, still in my shelf, but not played yet.
Then I've got Dark Watch, and I hope it's not completely in French, because it says on the back, Jeu et manuel en français, which means game and manual in French. I hope I can choose English or German. Then I've got Dead or Alive 1.
You can't go wrong with that.
Dead or Alive 2.
2 I have for the Dreamcast.
And I already have Dead or Alive 3 and the Ultimate Volleyball for the Xbox. So now I have, I guess I have all Dead or Alive games for the Xbox. I've got 2. Well, that's another cable. I've got 2 AV cables for the Xbox. You can't have enough AV cables.
Yes.
I've got...
can't have enough controllers.
I have one green controller for the original Xbox. I have another green controller for the original Xbox.
Controller mania.
Very, very long cables. One regular controller for the original Xbox, and another regular controller for the original Xbox, and they came, of course, with an original Xbox in very good condition.
Yeah, well, it looks really good.
Very good condition. It's the best condition that I have in my Xboxes. So I didn't need another Xbox. I already have 2 working ones. One is modded. This is not modded, but I paid so little money. I wanted one more Xbox controller. I would have preferred to get a Duke, but the Duke was, I think, $8 or $10. And these were single without the Xbox were $10. And I got 4 controllers and the Xbox and the AV cable and 2 games and those 2 games for $30. So yeah, that was a no-brainer.
Yeah, absolutely.
That was surely a no-brainer. Absolutely. $30 for an Xbox in very good condition, 2 games, yeah. 4 controllers with all the cables. I didn't even think about it. Yeah. Yes, I did think about it because I really didn't need another Xbox, but in the end, when they closed, it was still there. I asked for a discount and he said he would give it to me for $25 without the 2 games, but at least I wanted to have Serious Sam. Not sure about Dark Watch. I hope it's not only in French, because I don't speak French. But yeah, it was so cheap, I could not resist. I went over my budget again. No surprise with the Famicom, the Xbox, and this huge pile of Master System games. But it was totally worth it.
Yeah.
I probably have to stop eating by the end of the month for a week or so. But totally worth it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I also got a new cell phone. I already recorded a video about my new cell phone a month ago when I got it, but it was so hot. I had so much work to do that I didn't have the time to edit anything. You might have noticed that there was a little bit lack of videos for the last 2 or 3 weeks, just because I had far too much work. So I got a new cell phone with a really great camera. So I recorded some footage from the Retroverse. A lot of people were asking for footage. So I put this at the end of this video, but I think I already say goodbye. So, and enjoy the footage from the Retroverse. And I probably will record some footage again from the Game Valhalla, because I now have my camera always with me and don't have to think about picking it up, putting it there, and carrying it around the entire time. So, yeah. So, hope you enjoyed this video with my Metomaniac. We recorded some videos in German for his channel. And in November, he will visit me again. And then we will record some videos in English for my channel. Probably some videos for the Intertone and the Intellivision, because they have a lot of two-player games, and this is my only opportunity to play two-player games with a real human and not with myself. Playing with yourself is not that great.
It depends.
Okay. Don't let Baby Jesus hear that.
Ah, he got some Swiss chocolate, not to forget.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Now, the Swiss are really good at making chocolate. Mm. And he's always bringing chocolate from Belgium to Switzerland.
Yeah, this dark noir chocolate. I really love this from Belgium. I don't know why, but it's to me it tastes better. But yeah, this is another story. Okay. So yeah, I have nothing more to say. Well, hope you enjoyed this video, and you can see me then later on this year also doing some English gameplay videos. I'm really looking forward to play this never played Intertone games. So
it's even more simplistic than the Atari games, and but that doesn't mean that they can't be fun.
Yeah, we had lots of fun playing some Atari games yesterday. So
yeah
I'm really looking forward to come here again and to do some nice videos for you. So stay tuned, watch his channel, and if you like, watch my channel. But at the moment I don't do any English speaking videos anymore, but if you just want to see how a game looks like or how it plays, so you can come to my German channel Tomaniac, zock mal wieder, and yeah, hope to see you there. So that was my 50 cent.
Yeah, and I give the other 50 cents.
So,
you will see, now you will see some impressions from the Retroverse. I have no clue how much material I actually recorded. I went through recorded with my cell phone, and maybe 5 minutes, 10 minutes, probably not more, because it's just a bunch of boxes with games.
Yeah.
You don't really see a lot. It's always the same. On every retro fair, it's the bloody same thing. There are some boxes,
mm-hmm.
some games on the table. You can see some prices, but seriously, if you buy more than one game, you can always haggle for a discount.
Yeah, normally.
So it's a little bit academic, but it seems to be popular and it's not much work, so I just do it. Hope you enjoy it and really thank you for watching.
Bye, folks!
Thank you.